Hello, and welcome to the Weeaboo Zone. Today I'm going to talk about manga. Manga that I like, manga that I dislike. I've been meaning to do this for a while, so let's get started. That looked a lot cooler in my imagination.
This is the introduction song. It's not very good, but it's not too long.
Okay, I'm going to start with the manga that I like first, and then I'm going to move on to the ones that I didn't like. So, first one that I like, I actually talked about a little bit in my last review compilation video, is Gameron. Now this one is very simple. It's just about a daimyo during the Tokugawa era who wants to know which martial arts school in his domain is the best, so he gets all his sons together and has them each choose a different school, and then there's a whole tournament where they all fight each other, and the whole series is basically just about all these awesome fights that it has. And I talked about it in more detail, so I don't want to repeat myself too much, but, like, if you're just looking for something that's pure action and fun, then Gameron will probably be right up your alley. Next up is Bleach. Now, I know this one, I know this one is going to be a bit controversial, because Bleach has its detractors. You know, it was one of the most popular manga in the world for a while during its heyday. It was one of the big three, you know? But I can't help it. I really like Bleach. It's similar to Gameron in that, you know, there's a bunch of action and fights, and that's the main draw, but there is other stuff to it, because this is basically just about a kid who can see ghosts and stuff, and then one day he learns, like, oh, hey, there's, like, demons and shit, so he becomes a Shinigami, or God of Death, or Soul Reaper, as they call it in the dubbed version of the anime, not sure why they went with that, but, you know, he can see these demon things, and he goes off to fight them, and then it gets crazier and crazier as time goes on, and, you know, the plot, I'm not going to say is amazing, but it's a lot longer than Gameron, which leaves it room for stuff like twists and turns, and it has a much larger character cast, and they all, well, not all of them, but, and a lot of them do actually get some development, and they change over time, and there are, like, things that happen that are unexpected, and the world expands over time. So, while yes, the action and the fighting are some of the, is really the main draw, and I mean that, like, some of my favorite fights that I've ever read in manga are in Bleach, but that, while that is the main draw, there is other stuff there, so I really like Bleach. Next up is Berserk. Now, anyone who recognizes that poster, obviously you know that I'm a fan of Berserk, and I have been for a long time, and unfortunately, the mangaka, the author, just passed away recently on May 6th. Rest in peace, Kentaro Miura. And so I don't think we'll ever get a proper ending, but it's still a phenomenal series. I still think it's worth checking out. It starts off with this guy named the Black Swordsman. His real name is Guts, and he's going off, again, killing demons and stuff, because that's a common theme in manga, and he's specifically searching for this one guy named Griffith, and at first we don't know why. But very early on, it switches into a flashback, and it stays in flashback for a very, very long time, just going over Guts' whole backstory and what led up to this point. And that, I think, is one of the best parts of the series. And then after that, it goes back to the present, and it's him continuing his quest for revenge. And Berserk is mostly known for being super, super dark and depressing at times. And it is, yes, but I'm okay with that, because it's not just edgy for the sake of being edgy. It actually does explore all these dark elements, and it does show, like, what it's like to be a person who has to deal with this. Like, for example, Guts has been around violence and fighting his entire life. Like, that's pretty much all he knows throughout most of the series. And so it really explores, like, okay, how this affects his ability to form meaningful relationships with other people. Just as an example, and I don't want to get into other stuff because of spoilers, but, like, if you are a fan of dark fantasy stuff, then I would at least check Berserk out, because it's a very intelligent exploration of that genre. If you're not, then I don't know if this would appeal to you. And I just want an excuse to bring this up. Like, last year when I did that video on my terrible novel that I wrote when I was 15, that one was really dark and edgy with no point to it. And part of that is because, like, yeah, I was a fan of Berserk at that time, and someone in the comments even said, that Berserk poster on your wall suddenly makes a lot more sense, which, it hurts a little, it does, but, you know, that is accurate. Berserk is great. Next up, Vagabond. Now, Vagabond is, this one's historical. It's not, like, a 100% true story, but it's at least based on real events. Like, it's based on the life of Miyamoto Musashi, who was a samurai who lived, around the end of the Warring States era and when it was transitioning into the Tokugawa era, so that was a pretty important time in Japan where the samurai were no longer as important as they used to be because the fighting had died down. And this is a fictionalization of that. And this one also is pretty dark and it gets a little heavy at times, but it is really good. All the fights are a lot of fun, and it goes into a lot of detail about, like, why people fight and, like, what purpose there is to it, especially now that most of the wars are over. And even then, like, without the wars being over, most of the wars are fought with, like, guns and arrows now, so swordsmanship isn't that important anymore. Like, how does a man like Musashi make his way in that world? And if you are like me and you recently watched Yasuke on Netflix and thought, well, that was trash because you were hoping for it to just be a regular historical anime and not bring in a bunch of mecha and shit, then Vagabond will probably sate that desire for you. Witch Hunter. Now this one is, okay, technically it's a Korean manhwa, but I don't actually give a shit. It's close enough. And this one is basically, there's witches that came out and they're super powerful and they've taken over most of the world. And the only people that can fight against them are the Witch Hunter organization. So enter our intrepid main character who fights witches really well. And that, I could go into more detail, but that is the gist of it. And this one, it is kind of dumb. Like, it, in a lot of ways, it's like just a regular shonen action series. In fact, I would just say, yeah, it is just a regular shonen action series. But it's a lot of fun. It knows what it is. It just has fun with it. And the story structure is a little weird, which I found off-putting. Some people I've heard praise it, and basically what it'll do is it'll show something happen, and then it'll go into flashback for like 10-15 chapters to show what led up to that point. So you're wondering that whole time, like, whoa, how'd the characters get into this predicament? You know, that sort of thing. And I don't know, I didn't like that, but you might, and it's just, I don't have a lot to say, it's just a fun series. Angel Densetsu, which I believe translates out to The Legend of Angel. This one is about a guy in high school who looks really scary. Like, he just looks like he'd be a bully and people are afraid of him. But he's not. He's actually just the nicest guy ever. And this is actually just a regular school comedy, which, yeah, there are a few fights in there, sure. And they're kind of fun, but they're mostly, I mean, they're played for laughs for the most part, because while he's not a bully, he's the nicest guy ever, the main character guy still does get into fights now and again, and he's really good at doing it. And one little bit of trivia I want to add is that this was written by the same guy who later went on to write Claymore, which I've never really gotten into Claymore. Like, it's not bad, I just haven't gotten around to finally getting into it. It's just, you know, it's one of those things, it's on my to-read list, which basically means I'll never read it. But I do find it funny how he went from school comedy stuff with very little action in it to that dark, bloody action fantasy that was Claymore. But, you know, whatever the case, Angel Densetsu, it's a pretty good series, it's fun. This one I think is going to be controversial as well. It is Rosario Vampire. Now, again, remember, I'm talking about the manga, not the anime, because the anime, while it is kind of fun in its own way, is very different from the manga. And this one is about a guy named Tsukune. He's just a regular Japanese schoolboy who transfers to a new school, which turns out to be in another dimension, and it's full of monsters. So, like, werewolves, vampires, fairies, like, that sort of shit. And he's being the only human there, he's in trouble, but he immediately makes friends with a vampire girl named Mocha, who constantly wears a little rosary, a cross around her neck. And so that keeps her powers suppressed, but when she takes it off, she becomes a, you know, full vampire, and she's super powerful and stuff. And I, for the most part, this series, at least it starts off as just a harem comedy. And I don't think it's particularly good at that, but it is better than a lot of other entries in the genre, if that makes any sense, because, I mean, the average level of quality for the harem comedy genre is extremely low. Like, there is no bottom to it. But anyways, Tsukune is a likable enough guy. Most of the other characters, including Mocha and the other harem members, are likable enough. And while they start off as stereotypes or cliches, tropes, whatever you want to call them, they do develop later on and they become different people. They become better people. They become more likable as characters as well. And there are how do I put this? There are a lot of things that go very wrong after a while, and so the series transitions from being just a harem comedy to being more of an action-adventure tale. And this is actually pretty good, I think. Like, I'm not gonna praise it too much. This is supposed to be a recommendation video. Why am I, like, qualifying my statements so much? But I think it is pretty good as an action-adventure series. Not the best I've ever seen, but it does have some fun fights. It has Tsukune going from, like, this regular schoolboy to actually being kind of a badass fighter. And all of his friends are pretty good at fighting in their own right. It's like, it's a fun series when it gets to that point, and it's not terrible before that point either. And, well, okay, how do I even put this? There is a weird twist near the end regarding Mocha's identity. I'm not gonna go into it, I'm not gonna spoil it right now, but, you know, when she takes off the rosary, it's not just her powers that come out, she actually has a different personality that is inside of her most of the time. They're usually just referred to as inner and outer Mocha. And the relationship between the two of them seems straightforward at first, but it gets really weird near the end, and I thought it was a very dumb twist. But at the same time, it is one of the only harem comedies I've ever seen that has a definitive ending. It doesn't just end with, like, well, they continued their hijinks forever. Like, it was pretty good. Suzuka. Now, this one is kind of just a regular romantic drama story, I guess. Like, it's fun, you know, it's basically just Japanese kids in high school, and they go about their lives, and they fall in love and stuff, and it's not really constant drama. It doesn't feel the need to do that, so it feels a bit more realistic, but at the same time, there's constantly, or not constantly, but there are a bunch of situations where the characters, no matter what decision they make, it's still gonna hurt somebody. So it comes down to, like, okay, well, what do I want with my life? And what am I willing to give up to achieve that? So it's actually pretty mature in that regard. And I can't go into too much detail about that because it's, you know, spoilers, but it's a fun little romance there. You know, I'm not gonna say it changed my world or anything, but I did enjoy it. It was a fun series. Now we're getting into manga series that I dislike. And when I say dislike, this ranges all the way from just mild, I wasn't the biggest fan, to this just bitter, seething hatred. Okay, so this is gonna run the gamut. First up is 20th Century Boys. Now this one, I really like the first half of this one, because it starts off, this guy, his sister came back from joining a cult a couple of years before the story began, and handed him her infant daughter, and he's been raising her for a couple of years. And his sister just disappeared, he doesn't know where she went, and then there's this cult that appears, and they start doing crazy stuff, and it's so hard to go into any real detail about it, because the thing that really sucked me in at the beginning was the mystery, and wondering, like, okay, who's running this cult, what's their goal, what are they willing to do to achieve that goal, how are they going to stop them, and that really kept me riveted for the first half of the series. But once you get to around the second half, I started to realize that there haven't been any satisfying answers to these questions. You know, it's the J.J. Abrams school of writing. You know, they just constantly introduce more mysteries, more questions that need to be answered, and then you don't give any satisfying answers to that. You know, like, you gotta open the mystery box at some point, J.J. Abrams. But you know, I wouldn't say it's the worst thing ever, it's just, it seems more concerned with surprising you than it does with telling a compelling narrative. Black Clover. Now, this one actually came into the mainstream a couple of years ago when the anime adaptation got started, and the anime adaptation was terrible. And I will say the manga's better than that, but it's still not great. Like, okay, if you're looking for just, like, a regular shonen battle manga, like what you would have found back in 2010 or maybe 2005, even earlier, like, if you're looking for something like that, then I think you'll like Black Clover just fine. You know, it's full of tropes and cliches and stuff, but it seems to know that, and so they kind of just use, hey, chill out over there, Oscar, and so it kind of just uses those as almost a shorthand for various aspects of the story, I suppose. Like, it doesn't need to spend an entire chapter with a character monologuing about their backstory and everything. Like, it just sort of shows you what this character's like and gives you a brief little glimpse at it, and you get the picture from that. So some people have liked it in that sense, but for me, there's just not enough new there for me, so I couldn't get into it. Fairy Tail. This is another one that started off pretty good. Like, I loved Fairy Tail for 250 chapters, maybe 300 chapters, and then it became absolute dog shit. Like, it feels as though the author just stopped caring, which is weird because he wrote Ravemaster, and Ravemaster was pretty good. You know what? We'll just post hoc throw that onto the like list. Like, Ravemaster's pretty good. Check that one out. But Fairy Tail, it feels like he just gave up after a certain point, and I don't know why. I just don't know why. But, like, after a certain point, everything becomes resolved through the power of friendship. Like, every battle, even if the characters have been facing impossible odds and, like, oh, how are we going to defeat this guy? He's, I don't know, immune to all of our attacks or something. They're just going to defeat him through the power of friendship, which, that's annoying if you do it once, but if you do it constantly the way Fairy Tail did, then, oof, that's just, it made me actually angry at a couple of points, so I just gave up. And later I did go back and read through the last couple of chapters just to see the ending, and I was like, it's still not good. It's still pretty bad. It's still Power of Friendship defeating the evil bad guy. So, yeah, Fairy Tail, not good. All right, this one I'm gonna get shit for. I don't really even dislike this one, but I could not continue reading it after a certain point because One Piece. Now, One Piece, people talk about it very highly, and for good reason. You know, there's a lot of fun characters in there. The art style is goofy, but it's great. The world is huge, and it's fun to explore. A lot of the fights are fantastic. The problem is it's just so long. Like, I read it up until the beginning of the Wano Kuni arc, like when they first arrived there, and then I realized I just kind of lost interest and I wasn't that into it anymore, because, well, it's similar to 20th Century Boys, where, like, there's a lot of questions that have been brought up that I want answers to, and they're not giving us any answers, you know? Like, I'm aware that them finding the treasure is probably going to come, like, at the end of the series, but the fact that this shit has been going on since 1997, which, keep in mind, I was a year old when One Piece started. I'm 24 now. There is a limit, okay? Like, I have a limited amount of time on this earth, and I can't spend all of it just reading through this one series, even if I've already read the bulk of it. Like, let's say this point I stopped was, like, the three quarters mark. Well, that last quarter is still going to be longer than a lot of manga that I've liked, including ones that are on this list, like Gameron. You know, that's a fairly short series, but it's still really good. And, man, I just was endlessly frustrated with every arc not even really contributing that much to the greater whole. You know, like, you can have a lot of these arcs that are mostly self-contained if you still get, like, little bits of information about, like, the wider world and what's going on out there and, you know, some of the mysteries that have been intriguing us, but One Piece did not do that, and so even though I liked a lot of the individual pieces, after a while my goodwill just got sucked away. And so if you're looking for manga recommendations, I cannot recommend One Piece. I would advise you to stay away from it. And finally, we have my most hated anime of all time, The Irregular at Magic High School. Now, I'll admit, like I said, it's my most hated anime of all time. I haven't read much of the manga. It started off as a light novel, and then, you know, anime and manga were adapted from it. But there is a manga of it, so I'm putting it on this list because I hate it and I want to complain about it. So this one is a pretty standard setup as far as anime goes. It's like our world 60 or 70 years in the future, and magic has been revealed to the general public, you know, so pretty much anyone can learn how to use it now. It's not like a secret society thing anymore the way it used to be, which is kind of neat. And then enter main character guy, whose name I will die not remembering. I don't give a shit. And him and his sister transfer to this new magical high school, and that's it. That is, that's pretty much the whole story as far as I read. Or rather, as far as I watched. Okay, I should clarify. I watched a bunch of the anime, thought it was trash, read the light novel thinking it would be better, and it was slightly better, but it had its own issues, which I'll get to. And the main reason I hate this series so much is because it had potential. You know, I like the world it takes place in, And I like the way magic works and how they explain a lot of that is really cool. And whenever they go into those exposition dumps, I was super into it. But, man, there was no story to speak of, and all the characters were super annoying. Like, if you thought Kirito from Sword Art Online was an insufferable Mary Sue, then main character guy from Irregular at Magic High School will... I can't even think of a good comparison. He's 20 times worse than Kirito, though. Like, absolutely so much worse. Like, any magic that someone can do in this show, he can do better. And he also has a bunch of other stupid abilities that just come out of nowhere. Like, he can cancel spells that other people cast as they're casting them. He invents flying off-screen. Like, apparently no one else had ever figured out how to do flying magic, and he just... off-screen, he invented it. Like, his sister comes into his room at one point, and she's like, "Hey, you're floating!" "Yeah, I invented it." "Whoa, that's crazy." There's a weird sort of incest storyline where, like, the girl that is his sister, or rather she's pretending to be his sister, is very attracted to him, clearly, which is weird. But, like I said, they are in hiding from something, and they're really just pretending to be siblings, so I guess it's not as bad as it could be, but it is still a little weird and odd and off-putting. Like, I don't know why anime has that so much. I assume it's because no one in Japan has siblings, but it is still really weird to see it be so ubiquitous over there. And anyways, as I said, I did read the light novel, and it was better, because the anime had no plot whatsoever for, like, the entire first season. At one point, a terrorist organization that has never been mentioned before and never gets mentioned again comes in and fights some of the main characters, and then they defeat them through their sheer power of being awesome. And the light novel also doesn't have too much of a story, but I was okay with that because it was basically just pure exposition dumps. And sure, it kind of felt like I was reading a wiki about this world, but, well, that's better than what I was getting. You know, it's better than having to sit through 5 minutes of characters I don't care about jabbering to each other before I get the exposition dump, as opposed to this where I can just go in and read it. But I still had to stop reading after a while because I got to some point where the main character guy goes on this really long, like over a page long rant about Chinese people, where he's basically just saying, "Ah, these fucking Chinese people coming over here, stealing our jobs, raping our women, they need to go back to where they came from." And I was like, well, that just came right out of nowhere. I wasn't expecting that. And the thing is, if the character had been portrayed as being a racist and other people, like, criticized him for it or something, that would be one thing, but he's not criticized. All the other characters agree with him because apparently this is the author's real views, and he... just using this as an excuse to push those out there. So, yeah, Irregular at Magic High School is utter dog shit, and I hate it. I have friends who like it. I don't know what they see in it, but I hate it, and if you like it, I hate you, probably. So, anyways, that was just little video, couple of manga that I like and couple that I dislike. If you guys want me to talk more about this, I probably can. Like, I actually... for years, reading manga was kind of just what I did. You know, like, I would come home from school, and for hours afterwards, until I went to bed, I would just look through websites and find a bunch of manga, and I would read through them. And some I dropped early on, but a bunch I finished. So, I have a bunch that I can talk about if you're curious. But anyways, that's it for this one. See you later. Bye.
Thank to all patrons, including $10 and up patrons, Apo Savalainen, Olivia Rayan, Brother Santotis, Carolina Clay, Christopher Quinten, Great Grebo, Joel, Carcat Kitsune, Liza Rudakova, Lord Tiebreaker, Madison Lewis Bennett, Micaphone, Sad Mardigan, Samuel Nevin, Tobacco Crow, Tom Beanie, and Vivictus. You guys are the best. If you want to get your name on here and get your things in other videos, vote on other videos, become patron, give money. I need money to live, to eat, to pay rent. I need money. Please help me out here. If you can't, then rate, comment, subscribe to channel. That's also good. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.